John F. Kennedy was assassinated on November 22nd, 1963. Thank you. Thank you. I met with Dr. King on November 23rd, 1963 at LaGuardia Airport. But as he was getting off the plane, and I could, and we were getting near one another, he talked to me, but it was like he was talking to the world. Mm. He said, "You see, if they can kill the president, they can kill anybody. Mm. Stop all this nonsense of trying to protect me. They can kill the president." That's, I remember saying that. The second thing I remember is that in the eulogy for the four girls who were died in the bombing, in the dynamite bombing of the 16th Street Baptist Church on September 15th, 1963, I was standing inside midway in that prayer. And I had, it was the first time I ever seen Dr. King cry in public, as he was giving this very powerful eulogy. And his tear, and his tears were mixed with anger, because if you read the text of this eulogy, he is he's saying that the poor girls were not just killed by the dynamite, the direct blast from the dynamite blast, but they were also killed. And he went in the midst of a whole list of things, by the Negroes who didn't do this, about public officials. Beautiful, but very powerful. He was crying, started to cry. And I've never seen him cry in public. Now the other thing was the side of humor. I grew up in a boarding school. So, you know, when we traveled, we hardly ever ate out of the restaurant when we were two people. Black food restaurant. But most of the time we stay in somebody's home and it would fix us a nice meal. And, you know, we'd be sitting in this kitchen and dining room, and Martin would say to the host, "Please don't sit me next to Clarence." You know, he's dying. You know, he had this devilish smile. "Do not sit me next to Clarence." He said, "I love the brother, but please turn your head," and he will snatch the chicken right off your head. And it was true.